students, I am Krishna Kanjani from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the online lecture series on kinematics and theory of machine. In this session, we will learn about introduction to mechanisms and machine. So let's start this session with basic introduction. So in this subject, we will learn first chapter, that is introduction to mechanisms and machines. So first of all, we have to learn that what is machine. And to learn about the machine, we have to follow the path as shown in this. Okay, so first we have to learn what is kinematic link, and then we will study about kinematic pair. In our previous session, we have learned that a kinematic link is nothing but an element which is having a relative motion with respect to the other element. Okay, so after learning about kinematic link, now in this session, we will learn about kinematic pair. So let's learn what is kinematic pair and various types of kinematic pairs. So, over here, as you can refer, let's learn first about the word pair. Now, pair means combination of two objects. So, over here, as we can refer that this combination can be termed as a pair. But now, how can we define a kinematic pair if we are producing two combination of two links which are producing completely or successfully constrained motion, then we can term it as a kinematic pair. Okay, so let's consider one example over here. So, first example, over here you can refer as the fixed block. Okay, so this link number 1 is a fixed block, and over here the link number 2 will reciprocate inside this fixed block. Okay, so over here we are able to understand that in whatever direction we will give motion to the link number 2, it will be moving in a predefined direction as reciprocating motion. Okay, so over here we can term it as a kinematic pair. Let's refer the second example. So in second example, again the link number 1, over here you can refer that link number 1 is fixation. Okay, now with respect to this fixation, link number 2, that is your L-shaped link, this link can rotate. Okay, so these two combinations can be termed as a kinematic pair. Okay, now after learning about kinematic pair, let's learn types of kinematic pairs. Now, kinematic pairs are classified according to mainly three categories. Let's learn one by one. So, first category, first type of kinematic pair, that is classified according to the relative motion between two pairs. Okay, now over here, as we have referred that kinematic pair is a combination of two links. Now, these two links are moving in which manner, that will define us the first classification, that is according to the relative motion between these two links. Okay, now second classification will be according to the contact between them, how they are connected with each other, that will define us the second type of kinematic pair. And the third classification, that is according to the type of closure, or we can say the how they are mechanically or they are connected by other means. Okay, so in this way, we can simply classify these kinematic pairs into various 9 types. Okay, now let's learn this all the 9 types one by one. In your GTU examination, this will be the most important question, because many times they will ask the question that classify kinematic pairs in 7 marks. Either they will ask that or explain any one type in 7 marks. Okay, so let's learn one by one. So the first one, that is type of relative motion between them. Okay, so now as they are moving relative to each other, then which type of motion is producing? So over there, the first one, that is known as a sliding pair. Okay, so now over here, as the first type, as the name indicates, it is a sliding pair. What it means? That the first component will be sliding with respect to the other component. Over here, the first example, you can refer that piston and cylinder arrangement. Now this piston is reciprocating inside the cylinder, and this type of motion is sliding nature. Let's consider the second example. Once again, we can consider that fixed block, and with respect to this fixed block, your rectangular slot, and with respect to this fixed block, your rectangular block will be sliding. Okay, now the third example, this is an object which is used in a lathe machine. Okay, this one is known as a guideway and tailstock. Now over here, with respect to this guideway, your tailstock will be sliding over this band. Okay, so that is the best example of a sliding pair. Now let's learn second one. Second one, turning pair. Now as the name indicates, turning pair, it means first component will be turning with respect to the other component. How this can be termed? So over here in this diagram you can refer that with respect to this fixation, now this fixed point is termed as link number 1. Okay, now with respect to this link number one, your second component is continuously rotating. Okay, this is known as a turning pair. Okay, so that is a simple example where we can observe that with respect to link number one, link number two is forming a turning pair. Similarly, with respect to link number two, link number three is also turning. And similarly, with respect to link number three, fourth number link is also turning. Okay, so this is a way in which we can say that all the pin joints can be termed as a turning joints. Other example is shaft rotating inside the hub. Okay, so let's refer this example over here. As we can observe that this hub is a stationary object. Okay, with respect to this hub, if we consider that your shaft is rotating, then this will form a kinematic pair, which is a turning pair. Okay, so this is about the second type, that is turning pair. Let's learn the third one. Now the third type, rolling pair. Okay, now if the first component is rolling with respect to the other component, then it is termed as a rolling pair. Now how we can consider? So over here the example is simple ball bearing. Over here you can refer that this outer casing will be a stationary component, and if we consider the inner casing is the other stationary body, then with respect to these two bodies, your spheres, which is in between this outer and inner casing, will be totally rolling inside them. Okay, so how they will be working, you can refer over here. So now this rotation of your outer casing is produced due to the rolling of these balls. Okay, so that is a basic example of rolling pair. Fourth type, that is known as a screw pair. Now as the name indicate, all the screw and nut combinations can be termed as a screw pair. But now how they are different from other three? So if you consider the working of screw pair, then over here you can refer that this, when you advance nut inside the screw, then over here first motion is a turning type of motion, and the second motion is sliding, because over here you can refer that your nut will be sliding on the periphery of your nut. So over here your nut will be sliding on the periphery of your screw body. Okay, so over here sliding and turning, both the motions are taking place at a time. So that's why this is known as a screw pair. Okay, now let's learn the fifth type of pair, that is known as a spherical pair. Now as you can refer over here, so with respect to this fixed body, your second body is able to rotate in 360 degrees. Okay, so over here how we can consider that, if we consider a fixed body, and with respect to this fixed body over here, you can refer that this one is your fixed element. With respect to this fixed element, if you are making your object which is in a spherical shape, and due to this spherical shape it can rotate in 360 degree, so it is the best example of a spherical pair. Over here we can consider many examples. For example, joystick of your games. Okay, whenever you are playing games, okay, you will use joysticks, and these joysticks are able to rotate in 360 directions. Same way we can consider the side mirror of your vehicles. Okay, they are also able to rotate with 360 degree rotations. So these are the basic examples of your spherical pairs. So in this way we can say that the first type, that is types of kinematic pair according to the relative motions. So all these first five are classified according to how they are moving with respect to the other component. Okay, now let's learn the second type of classification, that is nature of contact between them. So in that, the first one, which is known as a lower pair. Now over here, when two components are connected in such a way that when they are moving with respect to the other one, they will be having a surface contact between them, then it is termed as a lower pair. Now how can we define that it is a surface contact? So let's consider one example. So the first example, let's consider a sliding pair. Okay, now over here with respect to this fixed body, your rectangular slot is reciprocating. Over here the entire surface of your rectangular block is in contact with your fixed blocks. So that's why it is termed as a surface contact. Second example, we can consider this one as a turning pair. Okay, so over here again the entire surface of your shaft is in contact with the hub. Okay, the third example we can consider as a screw pair. Again the entire surface of your nut body is in contact with the screw body. So all the, we can say that sliding pair, turning pair and screw pairs are the best examples of lower pair. Now the second one, that is the seventh type, we can say as a higher pair. Now, what is the difference in that? So, in that case, if the contact between two bodies is a point or line, then we can term it as a higher pair. Okay, let's consider the example that is a gear machine. Okay, over here in this diagram, you can refer that the both the gears are transmitting power from the gear number 1 to gear number 2. Over here, they will be making always a point contact. Now, how it is? So, let's consider this diagram. So, over here, you can refer that as the gear number 1 is rotating, the tooth of gear 1 is slightly meshing with gear number 2 and which is making a point contact. If we consider that they are making a line contact, entire line or we can say entire depth of gear number 1 is inserted inside gear number 2, then the smooth movement of gear number 1 and 2 is not possible. Okay, so for smooth movement, it is always required that they both will be having only a point contact. Over here, you can refer that this red point is indicating the point contact over here. Now, if we consider the width of this gear, then we can term it as a line contact. Okay, let's consider the second example. We will study this Kamen follower system in our next chapters. But over here, we can consider that this element number 1, which is completely rotating, can be termed as a cam. And with respect to this completely rotating element, your element number 2, or we can say the kinematic link number 2, which is reciprocating, this component is known as a follower. So over here, we can refer from this figure that the point contact is, if we consider the planar body only, then we can observe that it is making only a point contact. And if we consider the width of this follower, then we can say it is a line contact. Okay, so simply the second classification is mainly depending upon how they are making contact between them. If they are making surface contact, then they are termed as a lower pair. And if they are making point or line contact, then they are termed as a higher pair. Okay, now let's learn the third type of classification, that is type of closer, or we can say that how they are connected. Okay, so the third classification of kinematic pair. Now over here, the first one, that is known as a self-closed pair. Now self-closed means that these two components are connected by themselves. They are mechanically constrained. Over here you can consider this example. So for in example number 1, the design is made in such a way that they will be always in contact between them. Similarly, example number 2 and example number 3, we can refer that their design is made up in such a way that they will be always in a mechanical contact between them. Okay, now with respect to this self-closed pair, the second type, which is known as a force-closed pair. Okay, over here, if they are connected with some mechanic, they are not connected due to their mechanical designs, but they are connected due to the gravity, or we can say them external forces, then it is termed as a force-closed pair. Over here, the cam and follower mechanism, once again, this rotating element is your cam, and with respect to this cam, your follower is oscillating. Now over here, you can refer that if you will not connect this spring between them, then your follower will not oscillate, because over here, it will move in random direction. Okay, so to make it a kinematic pair, where it can move a predefined motion, then over here, we have to accommodate this spring. So this spring force is enabling these two components to be joined. Okay, so that's why they are termed as a force closed pair. Okay, so this is the third classification of kinematic pair, that is based on the nature, or we can say closure, of the kinematic links. Okay, so this is all about kinematic pair. Now after learning kinematic pair, we will consider that after learning this concept of kinematic pair, now we have to learn the concept of kinematic chain, and that will help us to design mechanisms. Okay, so about the kinematic chain, we will learn in our next session. Thank you.